Operation IceBridge is fundamentally about climate research, but it never misses an opportunity to teach. While deployed at the always windy southernmost tip of Chile, the team hosted the U.S. ambassador, as well as the space agency's chief scientist.
This is very exciting to be part of this NASA IceBridge mission, and shows, you know, what good work we do with the State Department, with NASA, in promoting science diplomacy in countries like Chile.
The pair traveled with the research team for an actual mission over Antarctica. There they got a first-hand opportunity to see how the team does the job.
IceBridge is vital because it's studying our changing Arctic and our changing Antarctic to help understand the real, true effects of climate change that are happening in these regions.
Climate change presents intellectual challenges. It's tough to grasp transformations at the planetary scale when we live our lives at the human scale. But global climate is changing, and because it concerns the whole planet, NASA sends teams around the world to collect essential data. Operation IceBridge is just such a mission. It deploys flying research laboratories like this to repeatedly measure changes in polar ice. That's what brought the team to Punta Arenas at the southern tip of Chile. It's the best location for staging regular missions over Antarctica. It also afforded the U.S. diplomatic mission first-hand experience with something that's ultimately beneficial for broader goals.
So the studies that we're doing on climate change are critical to our mission. Our embassy is very supportive of this. It's part of my job and part of our jobs as ambassadors to promote good relations between countries. And this kind of activity, this kind of mission, does exactly that.
IceBridge may be about climate research, but as underscored by the ambassador's fact-finding trip today, it's also a diplomatic opportunity. Working with our Chilean hosts reinforces the value of scientific collaboration internationally. After all, everyone shares the same planet. From somewhere above Antarctica, I'm Michael Starobin.